how to use BPC-157 and thymosin beta-4 or TB-500. This is one of the most fascinating subjects that I get to speak on because I love these peptides. These peptides are like really close friends. In fact, we call these the Wolverine stack because they help your body heal and recover. And so for those of you who watch this video, there's a couple things you're going to get out of it. One, I'm going to show you how it helps your heart. Number two, I'm going to show you how it helps your brain. And number three, I'm going to show you how TB4 or TB500 and BPC-157 help you build muscle mass and recover from injuries. First of all, what is BPC-157? This is a peptide that is roughly 14 amino acids. There's fragments of BPC-157 as well, but the pure form is expressed in every single cell of your body. There's a receptor for BPC-157 to connect to it. What happens when your body has adequate levels of BPC? You get better nitric oxide production. You get better what's called VEGF, this vascular endothelial growth factor, so your blood vessels get all healthy. And it also seals up the leaky gut because most of the BPC-157 is naturally made by gastric secretion. So all the stuff your stomach's doing, it's releasing BPC-157. Now, TB-500 is technically a fragment or a synthetic version of the natural expression called thymosin beta-4, which is made by your thymus gland. Now, the thymus gland regulates the immune function, and it's basically like the training ground for all of the intelligence of your immune system. So TB-500, actually, in some of the doctors that I've spoken to about the difference between TB4, TB-500, they actually prefer TB-500 because it seems to turn on genes just a little more readily, but I personally prefer using TB4 because I like things to be as natural as possible. So with that said, you guys can blow up the chat box and let's have a debate about it. Put your comments below. What do you like better, TB500 or TB4, the thymosin beta-4? So let's dive in. How does it help the heart? Well, number one, if you think of what angiogenesis is and collateral circulation, one of the things I learned when I was in school is when you have an artery that gets blocked or damaged, your body has this what's called collateral vascularity that takes place. So your body will actually compensate when there's damage to the vascular system by creating new blood vessels. And these networks, when they're forming, it's called angiogenesis. And so it's the formation of new blood vessels. These blood vessels, they carry all the oxygens, the nutrients, everything that you need. And by the way, your blood labs, if you want to know how to use BPC-157 and TB-500 appropriately, you want to grab blood labs and then we can dose it very effectively. As we get into this, here's how you can use it for your heart. If you're trying to increase your VO2 max, you're going to want really good vascularity. If you've had some type of congestive heart failure or any kind of cardiovascular issue, whether it's asthma, you've had angina, maybe you've got some myocardial infarction, you had an issue with the COVID vaccine, well, TB500 and BPC-157, I'll refer to it as the Wolverine stack as well, this is a really good formula for you. And typically what you want to do is you want to dose it a little bit higher of a concentration. So you want to jump in and be using about 25 units every single day, and you want to go up to 90 days on, and then you can take about a month off. The thing I love about them is because every single receptor in your body is dependent on these two molecules, these two peptides, this is a peptide stack that you don't have to cycle off as frequently as you would, you know, if you're taking like a growth hormone peptide or even some of the mitochondrial peptides. You don't want to have that over rotation. I've been on these two peptides more than any other peptide in my entire life, and I've been using peptides for roughly about 12 years. And I remember when I first utilized these, I was doing this crazy Peloton workout and then I go mountain bike. I was biking twice a day to see if I could really improve my cardiovascular fitness. And I actually was training so that when I go to Moab, there's this trail, it's called the Whole Enchilada, and you mountain bikers, you know what I'm talking about. It's one of the most epic trails in the United States. And I wanted to see how fast I could get through the Whole Enchilada. And it's a slug. It ends up being about 30 miles from top to bottom. You start at the very top of the La Salles, you know, you have a little bit of climbing. I think it's roughly like 500 feet of climbing. And then you've got about, you know, 5,000 feet of descent. And when you get to the bottom, when you're in Moab, it gets hot. and you start where it's cold and there's still snow, and then you get to the bottom. But my goal is always get it under 4 hours, and now it's get it under 3 hours. But it was when I started using BPC-157 and TB-500, it exploded my ability to have better endurance, but also to recover. So the next day we could go ride again. We'd go to Slick Rock, or we'd hit, you know, Magnificent Seven, or we'd hit Captain Ahab's, all those fun trails there. And the fun that I was able to have the next day, the following day, where I could ride mountain bike, you know, 3-4 hard days in a row and not feel the strain on the body, was phenomenal, because it's also anti-inflammatory. And this is one of the most important things when it comes to your body's ability to recover, and when it comes to vascularity, is that whole ability to recover. And so think of this as your recovery tool. And on days where you exercise really hard, here's a little pro tip. You can inject yourself 2 times. So you can actually do it in the morning and in the evening. And I like doing smaller doses, these little micro doses, like maybe I do like 15 units at 15 units, especially if you think, you know, it's a bit of an investment if you're investing it twice a day. But just by having those pulses are really important. How does it work with the brain, and what can you do cognitively? Well, TB500, you can actually get it. We can have our pharmacist make it in eye drops. If you have any kind of eye damage, I have a client, she's got macular degeneration, and she was just at one of our brain retreats, and she said, my eyes are feeling so much better, and I feel like it's created more mental clarity for me. And that's the beautiful thing about the administration of this, because you can use TB500 as an eye drop. You can actually use it topically. You can inject it into the scalp if you've had hair loss. You can inject it into places of the body that are damaged. And then for those of us who've had autoimmune issues, TB500 is really effective for downregulating that autoimmune response, or what's called like mast cell activation. If your body's in this kind of triggered by everything and you have this chronic inflammatory reactive syndrome, I've seen BPC-157 and TB500 just stabilize that whole storm that your immune system's in. So the way that you can use it for your brain, BPC-157, you can actually, there's some pharmacies that make it as a nasal spray. My preferred method is anytime you've had any kind of head trauma, and we have a lot of elite athletes. We just had one of our Olympic cyclists come in, and she was hit by a car. Crazy. You drivers, watch out for the cyclists. And I know they're annoying, because I'm always like, man, there's nowhere for me to go, and you guys are going like 10 miles per hour. So it's a two-way street, but drivers, be careful, because the driver didn't even see her on the trail and just T-boned her, and she had a massive concussion. What we did is we did intranasal stem cells, and then we started using TB500 and BPC-157. She was using it every day, and it was like the lights turned on in her brain again. She felt alive literally within hours after the treatment. And so we've had her continually doing that, but now she has to get rid of them because she's competing again. And so you've got to be careful with that side of things, because if you are a professional athlete, you want to look out for WADA regulations, or the World Anti-Doping Agency, because these molecules, unfortunately, right now are not allowed. And so how does it work for the muscle, and how can you use it for the muscle? Well, for those of you who really want to bulk up and you're maybe in bodybuilding mode, here's how you use it. You want to use this peptide 3 times a week on the days that you're lifting. And if you're lifting 4 times a week, make sure you're taking some recovery days and use like ACE-031, your myostatin inhibitor. You do weekly injections of that. You take MOD-SC 2 times a week, maybe 3 times a week, depending on what your labs look like. And then on the days that you're doing, and you do that in between the lifting days, then the days that you're lifting is where you want to be doing heavier doses of BPC-157, thymosin beta-4, ideally when you go to sleep at night. I like doing an injection at night, and then I'll do oral in the morning. And those are great on my lifting days, because I can always feel like I can get another rep out of it. And I've got 19-year-old boys, and I just, it's really hard to keep up with them. They're getting all strong and bulky. And I'm like, I'm the alpha male here, guys. So, but it's the peptides that have helped me almost maintain an edge, but they're starting to get ahead of me, which is great. I love it. So thymosin beta-4, TB500, really simple ways. Hopefully that gave you some insights on how you can use it for your heart, your brain, and your muscle. And then the real way is make sure that you download a free copy of my peptide handbook. We've got a link in the show notes, and I will see you there.